returning to the place we've always belonged. Right here. Take me back to the garden. Lead me back to the moment I heard your voice. Take me back to
morning. Welcome to Barak Christian Church. As we celebrate the name of Jesus Christ on this morning, we welcome you to our live stream service this morning. And for the ones that are in attendance, we're just praising God and thanking God for just another day on this earth. Amen. As we begin to think about and remember the sacrifice, the ultimate sacrifice that Jesus died for all of our sins, that he died for us that we may be saved, that he died for us that we may have life abundantly. And so we come to celebrate and remember the sacrifice that was done on the cross of Calvary, the sacrifice as he was marched through the town, beaten, mocked, all for just you and I, so that on this day, that we may have life, that we may be able to approach the throne of grace and mercy on our own, not needing anyone to intercede on our behalf, but we have the right to go to God the Father ourselves. So we just want to thank God for that this morning. We want to praise God for all that he has done, all that he continues to do, even in despite of this pandemic going on for over a year, and it seems like we're moving in the wrong direction, but God is still moving. God is still blessing. God is still working. And I promise you, if you just trust him, if you lean on him, if you depend on him, there you will find yourself in no better predicament, no better situation, that you will find yourself having the strength to get past and get through some things that you never thought that you would be able to get through. And when you look back, if you even over this past year, you just look back at some of the things that you were challenged with, and you're still here. God deserves the rest. When you think about some of the trials that over this last year, you don't even have to look back that long. Just think about some of the things that you were challenged with. Things that some people don't even know that you were challenged with. But between you and God, you made it through. And there was nothing but the grace of God. Nothing but the grace of, nothing but his mercy, nothing but his grace and the power of the Holy Spirit that keeps us in our right mind. I'm telling you, some of the things that people have been through, they shouldn't even be in their right mind. But God has spared their mind. He is a mind regulator. So some of the trials and some of the circumstances that people have gone through and they're still in their right mind lets you know that God is a mind regulator. Amen. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Christ Jesus, Lord, we praise you, we honor you, and we magnify you. We thank you for this day that you have blessed us with. Now, Almighty God, we call for the power of your presence, your anointing, and your Holy Spirit to rain down fresh upon us this morning. Touch every soul that is in attendance. Touch every soul that is listening on the live stream audience. Touch every soul that will listen to it throughout the week, oh God. We pray your anointing in this place take over and take residence in our hearts and our lives and in this service. Oh God, we just come to give you our very best. So we want you to show up on us, Almighty God. Have your way in this place. In the name of Christ Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. Our scripture reading will be from Sister Tamiko Tucker, and then our music ministry, John Williams, is going to bless us in the music ministry this morning. Amen.
Good morning. Praise the Lord. This morning, I'll be reading to you Psalm 68, 1 through 8, and I'll be coming from the New Revised Standard Version. That's Psalm 68, 1 through 8. I'm sorry, 63. Psalm 63, 1 through 8. Oh God, you are my God. I seek you, my soul thirsts for you. My flesh faints for you. As in a dry and weary land where there is no water. So I have looked upon you in the sanctuary, beholding your power and glory. Because your steadfast love is better than life, my lips will praise you. So I will bless you as long as I live. I will lift up my hands and call on your name. My soul is satisfied as with a rich feast, and my mouth praises you with joyful lips. When I think of you on my bed and meditate on you in the watches of the night, for you have been my help, and in the shadow of your wings, I will sing for joy. My soul clings to you. Your right hand upholds me. I've just read to you Psalm 63, 1 through 8, the New Revised Standard Version, and may the Lord add a blessing to the hearers and doers of his word.
I went across the deep blue sea, couldn't find one to compare to your grace, your love, your mercy. Nobody greater, nobody greater than you. Searched all over, couldn't find nobody. Sing along, y'all. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. There's nobody great, nobody greater, no, nobody greater than you. One more time, y'all. I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. There's nobody greater, there's nobody greater, no, nobody greater than you. Let's take it up. Come on, Reverend Brian. No one can heal like you can. Oh, most holy one, you are the great I am. Awesome in all your ways, and mighty is your hand. It is you who carried out redemption's plan. It is he who carried out redemption's plan.
Searched all over,
hey.
Couldn't find nobody.
I couldn't find nobody.
I looked, couldn't find nobody.
There's nobody greater. There's nobody greater.
Nobody
greater than you.
Yeah.
I searched all over. I couldn't find nobody. I looked high, I looked low. I still couldn't find nobody. Nobody, there's nobody greater. There's nobody greater.
Nobody
greater than you.
Turn it up, y'all.
There's nobody greater. There's nobody greater, Jesus. No.
Greater than you.
Greater than you. There's nobody greater. There's nobody greater, Jesus.
Nobody greater than you.
Greater than you. Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
There's
nobody greater than you.
Nobody greater than you.
No, 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 no. One more time. There's
nobody.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
There's nobody greater,
nobody
than you.
Greater than you.
Greater than you. Greater than you.
Amen.
Nobody greater. Nobody greater.
Nobody greater than you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. How do you know that there's nobody greater? Nobody greater than him. Amen. I'm telling you, when just think about some of the things that you've been through. And even the prayers of a mother couldn't get you out. But when you went to God the Father, there was nobody greater. Nobody greater. That song will speak melodies to your heart when you, even in the worst of situations. There's still nobody greater than him. I'm telling you that will get you through, get you over, get you by, get you past, get you around, get you under, get you. There's nobody that can do it better than our God. And I'm telling you, when you believe that and trust that in every situation that you're going through, you will find out that even though we may have to struggle sometimes, and the Bible didn't promise us that we would never struggle or we might never go through some things. So even though we have to go through some things and some situations, but when you have God on your side, it just makes it that much easier to press your way on through because you have somebody that is greater than anything in this world. He's greater. There's no name above him, no name below him. Everything that has a name has to bow down to that name. So when you are in relationship with a name that conquers every name, hallelujah, you can make it through some things. Amen? Amen. We're going to ask Reverend Stephanie Atwater Kelly to come up with our pastoral prayer this morning. And we just want to continue to be in prayer for our community. The violence is still ticking up and, you know, seem to be ticking down in the St. Louis city, but now the county want to raise up in violence. So, you know, we got to keep on praying this morning and lifting up those who are still anti-vaccine. Lift them up. I pray God speak a word to their minds. I'm telling you, we have got to keep ourselves healthy and safe. And and the science speaks for itself. And I know us as Black community, we are skeptical because of the syphilis treatment that they did on the Blacks. So we are skeptical about vaccines, but we have got to get past that because we are dying. And now it's the younger generation is dying, the young adults and the kids, because they're the most skeptics with this vaccine. But we got to pray that spirit up off of us because God is still in control. Amen. So we're going to ask Reverend Stephanie Atwater Kelly to come up with our pastoral prayer.
Oh, bless you, God. Hallelujah. 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 Dear God, we thank you and we praise you, Lord. We magnify your holy and righteous name, O Heavenly Father. God, we thank you, O God, for who you are. We thank you for your goodness, mercy, and your grace, O God. And Father, humbly we come asking, O God, before your throne, asking, O God, for your forgiveness, Lord, for your mercy. We pray, O Lord, that as we've gathered here corporately together, O God, that we come with one heart and one mind, O God, asking, O God, on behalf of the people, Lord, that you would touch today, Lord, that you would move today, Lord, and that you would have your way. We come, Lord, asking that you would touch those who are sick and afflicted in their bodies, O Heavenly Father. Hallelujah. We ask for healing today, Lord. Hallelujah. We know that by your stripes, O God, your shed blood, O God, that by your stripes that we are healed, O Heavenly Father. And so we pray, O Lord, that you would go into hospital rooms today, Lord. We pray that you would touch those who are recovering, O God. Rachel Nord, O Heavenly Father, we lift her up as she's recovering, Lord. We pray, O Lord, that you would heal complete and whole. Touch diabetes, O God, even in my own body, O God. Give us a mind, O God, to want to live healthy, O Heavenly Father. Hallelujah. But we pray, O Lord, that you would give us a mind to be obedient, O God, to what we're supposed to do, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord. We pray, O Lord, that you would touch heart conditions, O Heavenly Father. Even broken hearts, O Heavenly Father. We lift them up to you today, Lord. We know there are some things that happens in our lives, O Heavenly Father, that causes brokenness in us, O God. But you are not just the healer of blood issues and bone issues and skeleton issues, O God, but you are a healer, O God, of our broken hearts, O Heavenly Father. And we thank you for being everything, God. We thank you that we can bring our problems and our issues to you, Lord. That we know, O God, that you have experienced them all, pain, O God, in every area, O God. For your body was broken and crushed, oh God, and you experienced it all. And you know what it's like, oh God. So we thank you that we can come to you, oh God, in the time of trouble, in the time of distress, oh Heavenly Father, and that you're there for us, oh God. You never leave us, oh God, and you're never alone, oh God. We pray that you would touch those who are bereaved today, oh God, that are experiencing, oh God, death, oh Heavenly Father, whether it be a son, a daughter, oh Heavenly Father, mother, father, oh God, in-laws, close friends, grandparents, aunts and uncles, oh God. We pray, oh Lord, we call out to you, asking for your comfort, oh Heavenly Father, for you said you'll never leave us, oh God. And we thank you, oh God, that you're able to give us a spirit of joy, oh God, that it will come in the morning, oh God. Help us to know, oh God, that with that trouble don't last always, oh God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And that one day we will smile again, oh God, when we least expect it, oh God. Help us to tap into you, oh Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus. We pray, oh God, that you would touch this sin-sick world, oh God. We pray, oh Lord, that you would touch leaders in the community, oh God, and governments, oh Heavenly Father, that they make right decisions, but that you would touch the people to go out and vote, oh Heavenly Father, and be a part of the solutions, oh Heavenly Father, in our neighborhoods, oh Heavenly Father. God, we come against crime. We come against violence. Hallelujah. We come against just wrongdoing, oh God, in the community. We pray, oh Lord, that the community would learn to be community, to love on one another, oh Heavenly Father, to help one another, oh Heavenly Father, and to look out for one another, oh Heavenly Father. But God, that starts with loving ourselves, oh Heavenly Father. Give us a mind, oh God, to love ourselves, oh God. For your word says to love you, the Lord God, with all our heart, mind, body, and soul, and to love our neighbors as we love ourselves, oh Heavenly Father. God, we pray, oh Lord, that you would teach us that way, oh Heavenly Father. And then that we would go out and do it, oh God. Let us not people who do what others do to us, oh God, but let us do what your word says to do, oh Heavenly Father. To be who your word says to be, oh Heavenly Father. To walk the way the word tells us to walk, oh Heavenly Father. We thank you, Lord God. We pray, Lord, that you would touch this our church, oh God, that you would bless and touch our pastors, oh God. Crown their heads with wisdom and knowledge from on high, Lord. Continue, oh Lord, to allow them to be the leaders that you have called them to be, oh God. And the vision, oh God, that is set forth in this place, oh God, let it flow, oh Heavenly Father. We cause your people, oh God, to come forth. And God, I prayed this morning, but I'm praying again, oh God, for every member that has come through Barak Christian Church. I pray that you touch them, Lord. If they're in a place where they're supposed to be, oh God, bless them, oh God. If they're standing still and don't know where to move, oh Heavenly Father, let them know there's no place like home, oh God. Let them come back, oh God, with a spirit of obedience, a spirit of wanting to be helped, oh God, a spirit of cooperation and collaboration, oh God, that we might be the house, the people that you have called us to be, oh God. There's a great vision in this house, Lord. Hallelujah. And we pray, oh Lord, that you would touch this house, oh God. Touch Barak, oh God, that we might receive a financial blessing, oh Heavenly Father. Hallelujah. So full, so complete, oh God, that we might be able to receive, oh God, and do the work, oh God, that the vision requires, oh Heavenly Father. And God, I want to be a part of that blessing process, oh God. Bless your people, oh God, that we might be a blessing, oh God. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus, to make our home, oh God, our church home, oh God, one that is ours, oh Heavenly Father, that we are part of. And God, we just thank you. We thank you for the word, oh God, that is going forth today, Lord, that it would go out and that it would touch hearts today and that it would mend, oh God, and that it would set free, heal, and deliver your people, oh Heavenly Father. God, let somebody tap into this live Facebook Live, oh God, and hear something, oh God, that make them want to stay, oh God, and let it be the word, oh God. Let it saturate their hearts, oh God. Prepare our hearts to receive your word, oh God. Turn it over, oh God, the fertile in our ground, oh God. Don't let it fall in the cracks, oh God, and let the sun come burn it up. Don't let somebody come snatch the word out of our hearts today, oh God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. We pray, oh Lord, for those who are traveling today, that you would keep them in your care. I pray for my own daughter as she's traveling, oh God. I pray for our pastors, oh God, as they prepare, Lord. I thank you, oh God, for all of those who are traveling and that your grace, oh God, would be with them, oh God. Keep us safe, oh God. Keep us, oh God, with a mind stayed on you, oh God. Hallelujah. Whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are pure, honest, and just, oh God. Hallelujah. Cause us to think on those things, oh Heavenly Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As we put our trust in you, our whole heart in you, oh God. For we have known, we've seen it done in others, oh God, that you have transformed minds and hearts and lives, oh God. And as you've done in others, oh God, we believe that you can do it in us as well, oh God. And so we thank you, oh God, for caring for us, for loving us. Oh God, so much so, Lord, that you sent your only begotten Son, hallelujah, to die just for us. And we give you glory and honor and praise for it. Bless this day, oh God. Bless our decisions that we have to make. Bless us in our careers. Bless us in everything we do, oh God. And let it be for your glory and your glory alone, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, amen. We thank you, Reverend Stephanie, for that pastoral prayer this morning. If you are in agreement, why don't you say amen? Amen, amen, amen. At this time, we want to welcome our visitors and guests. If we have visitors and guests in the house and on the live stream, we just welcome you this morning, and we greet you in the name of Christ Jesus. On behalf of our pastors, Dr. Lynn R. and Dr. Stacy A. Mims, we just welcome you to Barak Christian Church. And we pray that you feel welcome to praise God how you see fit in your life and in your experience, because we're going to praise God out of our experience and how we experience God for ourselves. So we just welcome you and we greet you in the name of Christ Jesus. And if it wasn't for all this COVID, we'll come by and give you a hug, but we just pass the peace on to you. Amen. And if we're the ones that are members that are online, if you just reach out online and drop a comment to welcome the guests that are on our live stream audience, amen. You are always welcome in God's house, and you are always welcome here at Barak Christian Church. Amen? Amen. At this time, we're going to go through our announcements, but before we go through those announcements, we want to take this time out to recognize and celebrate our own pastor, Dr. Lynn R. Mims, amen, celebrated with 73 years of life on yesterday, amen. So we just thank God for preserving him, giving him the strength, a 73-year-old man that can jog longer than I can, amen. I got to do a little bit better, amen, hallelujah. A 73-year-old man can out-jog me, and that's a shame, but we thank God for his life. We thank God for his dedication. We thank God for how he has poured out into so many, not only in Barak, but throughout the St. Louis metropolitan area, throughout this nation. I'm telling you, this man has a heart of gold and compassion for the people. And I'm just, you call him and he's there. And I'm like, he's just like an energizer bunny, just keep going. I say, Doc, you got to rest. He got to be there for the people, and God has blessed him to have the strength to continue to do it. We thank him. We love him. And if you haven't sent him a text message, Barak members, please do, because whenever you are in distress and you pick up that phone, he has never ignored a phone call. And so I don't know many congregations that has their pastor's direct cell phone number that is able to call whenever. And not only we call for our family members who are not even a member of the church, but he's still there. And that's dedication. So we honor you. We love you. We thank God for you. And we pray that God continues to bless more years unto your life. So 73 years of life for our own Dr. Lynn R. Mims, the pastor, co-pastor of this church, Barak Christian Church. We love you and we thank God for you. Amen. Amen. Well, let's go through some of these announcements. The prayer ministry. You are welcome to pray on the conference call prayer line every Sunday at 9:30 a.m. until 10 a.m. The meeting ID is 425-436-6371, and the PIN number is 590-6490. You do not have to be on the prayer team to pray. For more information, please contact Reverend Rosie Hall. Bible study. This Wednesday, August the 4th, we'll have Bible study at 7 p.m. on Zoom. The meeting ID is 860-1301-2979. The password is 450787. Next week, we will have both Bible studies at the regular scheduled time. So remember, this Wednesday, there's no morning Bible study, but there will be the evening Bible study. Barak Recovery Support Program, Addiction and Recovery Services are open to the public every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. Services include references, spiritual counseling, group and or peer support, and care coordination. Due to COVID-19, telehealth and other media outlets are available. Please contact Dr. Lynn Mims, the director, or Reverend William Lemons, the peer recovery support specialist, at 314-521-2243. The food giveaway program. We begin serving the community at 12 p.m. every Saturday. If you are interested in helping to prepare the boxes, please arrive at 9:30 a.m. And we go rain, shine, or snow. And we were in the rain, we still serving. So praise God for that. And we just thank God for the community, I mean, the partnership that we have with County Bobo, New Higher Heights, and the USGA so that we may provide a service to the community that is still in need. Our sick and shut in, continue to lift up Rachel Nord Russo. I'm about to call everybody going to be a reverend in a minute. Rachel Nord Russo, continue to lift her up. You have her number. Just give her a text and let her know that you're thinking about her as she continues her recovery. Amen. Amen. Those are our announcements. Govern yourselves accordingly. I'm gonna let our pastor take a break for his birthday. So I'm going to lift up the tithes and offering this morning. Just let him rest because he has truly been working. Amen. So at this time is our tithes and offering. And even in the pandemic, we still have a responsibility to continue to serve God in all. And we serve God in our finances. We serve God in our praise. We serve God in our worship. So even in this time of pandemic, we don't stop our giving. And God has continued to keep us and bless us. And, you know, we may have struggled through some times, but God continues to see us through. And I've never given and came up short in my own household. I've never seen it happen. I've given and my household has been blessed. I've seen that happen, but I've never seen myself give and come up short in my own household. And it's not all, your return is not always financial, and that's something that we have to break also. Your return is not always financial, because if you made it home and with that a stray bullet coming your way, someday, that's a blessing. Amen. Your health and your strength, that's a blessing. So we can't always look for the return financially, but God is blessing in other areas of your life. So we have many ways of giving. If you want to give by Cash App, it's the $Barack Church. By PayPal, it's barackchurch@att.net. Or you can go online to barackchristianchurch.org and click the online giving. We have Zelle, barackchurch@att.net. PayPal, you can text, not PayPal, but Apple Pay, 314-522-4911. Text that. Or you can mail at 7370 North Hanley Road at Hazelwood, Missouri, 63042. Or if you can't do that, call somebody. Someone will come get it for you. Amen. But there is no excuse. We are still on the battlefield. And even the ones in the house on today, if you need to swipe a debit card, Pastor Stacy has that at the back. So we're just trusting and believing in God in everything, in our finances, in our strength, in our health, in our homes. Whatever we have truly belongs to the Lord. He has just given it to us to use. But we still have to be obedient to his word. And that's that 10%. We get hung up on that 10%. If it's only a dollar, we'll give that 10 cent immediately. But when we start talking about thousands and 100, 2,000, 200, wait a minute, it's still that same 10%. Amen? Amen. Amen. So we're going to take the time out to lift up a blessing for our offering. Father God, in the name of Christ Jesus, Lord, we praise you, we honor you. We thank you for the offerings and the tithes and the gifts that were returned to your house. Oh, God, we trust you in everything that we do. So help us, even as we struggle sometimes, to remain faithful. And sometimes we may not want to make that commitment to 10%. But, God, I pray that you continue to prick our hearts, that we may trust you, knowing that you will never fail us and that anything that we ask in your name, Lord, your word said that you can do it. So I pray that you begin to enlarge our territories, even in the midst of this pandemic when things are starting to close down and it seems like finances and the economy is in a down spiral. But, Lord, we know that you are able to do anything far more than we can ask, think, or imagine. So I pray this morning, oh God, that every household that stands in the need, that you provide a blessing right now in the name of Christ Jesus. And as we continue to be obedient to your word, that you continue to do what your word said that you would do, that you will open up the windows of heaven and let blessings pour out onto our lives. Not that we may store it up for ourselves, that we may help the next one that is in need, for we are truly blessed to be a blessing. And for that, Lord, we thank you and we praise you. In the name of Christ Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to have Brother John Williams come back up for our music of preparation. And we still going to let our pastor have a break this morning. So this morning, the Reverend Rosie Hall will come and preach the word of God this morning. She is over the prayer ministry, the prayer warrior, over the dance ministry, dancing, but she still preached the word of God also. So throughout all her ministries, the most important one is to preach word of God, because that is what does the transformation. We sing, we praise, we dance, but the word of God does the transformation. So as we hear this last song, I pray that you pray with her and pray for her and pray that God bless and touch her, that he moves her outside of the box, that he takes her to a higher level, that he just expound her beyond her own capacity this morning. I'm praying God's spirit just falls fresh upon her right now, that any anxiety that she may be feeling, that God snatches it up and replaces it with his endurance, his strength, and his love, and his determination. I'm praying right now, oh God, that you use her like you never used her before. Oh God, set her soul on fire, set her feet on fire, set her hands on fire, that she may preach this word of God without conviction. Oh man, I mean with conviction and without hesitation. Amen. So as John Williams comes up with this song, prepare your hearts and your mind to hear the next preached word of God from Reverend Rosie Hall.
Amen. It's a song about prayer. Amen. Everybody, this is a fun song. Get on your feet, clap your hands. Come me up a little bit. Say ho. Everybody say ho. Everybody say ho. Come on. It's been a real hard couple of months. You're not having enough. But it's been hard for everyone, you're not alone. You've been hurting way too long. Let it go and just move on. Make your way down to the altar, hand it over and leave it there. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. Hey, so everything that you're worried about, you gotta bring it down. Oh, you want Jesus to work it out. He will, you gotta bring it down. All of your burdens, bring them down, and you're gonna get an answer to your prayer if you know you need a healing. You're sick of being sick, you need relief. You're tired of the pressure. You're tired of the stress and you want some peace. Come on and get your breakthrough. Haven't you been suffering? Oh, make your way down to the altar. Hand it over, leave it there. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. Hey, so everything that you're worried about, you gotta bring it down. Oh, you want Jesus to work it out. He will, you gotta bring it on. All of your burdens, bring them down, and you're gonna get an answer to your prayer if you, oh yes, you'll get an answer. Oh yes, you will, you'll get an answer. Come on. Oh, you gotta put it on, put it on, put it on. Oh, you gotta put it on, put it on, put it on. Come on. Oh, prayer, it changes things. Go to Reverend Rosie. Oh, yes, it does. It's prayer. You gotta bring it to the altar now. It's prayer. Ask Jesus anything you want to. It's prayer. So listen. You've been worrying and crying, crying and worrying, but you're not alone. You're not alone. No. See, you got a friend in Jesus, and he knows all about it, and he's gonna do what he promised you. But first, hey, everything that you're worried about, you gotta bring it on. All of your burdens, bring them down, and you want Jesus to work it out. He'll work it out, yeah. There's gonna be an answer to your prayer if you. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. Come on, you gotta put it on, put it on, put it on. Come on, you gotta put it on, put it on, put it on. Come on. Oh, you gotta put it on, put it on, put it on. The altar.
Praise God. Put it on the altar. I'm a living witness that that is exactly what we have to do. Amen. Praise the name of Jesus. Glory to his God. To God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to thank Sister Tamiko for reading the scripture this morning. Amen. And we're going to go ahead, and I'm going to, for those, for the reading of the scripture this morning, I want, for your ears, I want to read for the key verse, Psalm 63, 1 and 8. Psalm 63, 1 and 8. And it reads, O God, you are my God. I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh faints for you. Amen. Let us pray. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh in this house. Lord, have your way. Send your rivers of living water to touch every dry place in this place. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I praise you. And Lord, I glorify you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Almighty Lord. Before I get started, I want to thank my pastors. I love my pastors. I love my pastors. And I thank them for this. I humbly thank them for this opportunity to stand before you today. Amen. Amen. But there is a word from the Lord. I remember one Sunday morning, I was outside reading. Most of you, some of you know, I just love beauty. I love flowers. I love just the nature of what God puts out for us. And I'm just fascinated with it. So I was sitting outside on the swing on the front, and I was reading. And the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me. He said, go in the backyard. So I went around the backyard, and I'm looking. I'm like, okay, Lord, everything is in its place. Okay, then I walked around the side of the house. And when I walked around the side of the house where we have cut down some trees, they were big, huge trees, I looked over on the side, and there were some beautiful purple flowers, just bloomed, just beautiful. I didn't even plant those. I said, I didn't even plant those. I just went crazy. And the Lord said, I want to bring you through the dry and barren places of your life. Which brings to me my text. Look at your neighbors and those that are live on Facebook this morning and repeat after me. The presence of God is in your desert. Amen. Oh, the presence of God is in your desert. Yes, yes, yes. I don't care how spiritual you are, who you are, or where you have been, or what degree you have, or how much money you got in the bank. You will, in this life, experience a desert experience. Amen? It is how you respond to your wilderness or your desert experience determines your victory. The definition of wilderness and the desert is a wild and it's uncultivated region as a forest or a desert uninhabited and inhabited only by wild animals, a tract of wastelands, the absence of soil, dryness, barrens, and a lack of water. The two are very similar. The Bible used them as metaphors. So in the book of Matthew, Jesus was in the wilderness for 40 days and 40 nights. He was tempted by the devil. Abram's journey out from his father's house in Ur and sojourns with God in the wilderness of Negev. Hagar's maidservant to Sarah and concubine to Abraham encounters an angel of the Lord in the Negev wilderness after she flees from Sarai. Moses fleeing Egypt became a shepherd in Midian. It is here, as Moses tends to the flock of his father-in-law, that the Lord draws Moses to the wilderness of Horeb, to meet him. And then Isaiah was in the wilderness, and John the Baptist, just want to name a few. But here in the text, if you would allow me to use my spiritual imagination for a moment and visualize David as a tourist guide, one who guides others concerning the best direction to take. If anybody was capable of giving someone direction, it was David. For David was a man after God's own heart. Amen. David writes this psalm while he is in the wilderness of Judah, surrounded by desert lands. David gives us a picture of what the desert details concerning his physical condition. His heart, his soul was in a different place. Even though David wasn't doing his kingly duties, his entire focus was on the king. Amen. During this time, David fled from his enemies, but it gave him time that he needed to refresh his soul and to look to God. Although David was running from his enemies, he didn't even utter to God to rescue him. Now, he did that in the other books of Psalms, but this Psalms, he didn't do it. The first thing that David does is he navigates through this Psalm by speaking to our hearts as we travel on the journey in the wilderness. You might be in a dry place in your life, and you might be in a barren place in your life. You might even feel like your life is lifeless, and you are on life support. You're crying. You're at your wit ends, and you need the Lord to help you in this desert season. Well, I come to tell you that God wants to be present in your desert season. Amen? Here in the text, David shows us how God can be present during our desert season. The first thing David does is that he gets up early to seek the Lord. David had a prayer life. Thank you for that song, brother. David had a prayer life. When you are seeking God, you don't want to just lay in the bed and sleep all day. We got to get up. A lot of my coworkers, it's a joke. They laugh at me. Rosie was up. She was up this morning. I love to get up. I have to get up. It's part of my day. I have made it a routine to get up early. What you are devoted to is very important. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But I come to ask you today, what are you devoted to? Yeah. Is it your money? Is it your social media? Your cell phone? I'm talking to the young people today too. Your husband, your children, your career, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your significant other. You see, I'm like the songwriter said, I'm not here to entertain you. I'm here to give you a word that God has placed in my heart. Amen. The Bible said Jesus got up very early in the morning while it was still dark. He left the house. He went into a solitary place to be alone, to commune with the Father. He removed himself. We've got to remove ourselves if we want to seek God. David understood about the early morning. You see, early will I seek thee. The word early has not only the sense of early, but that of eagerness, immediateness, the first approach of light, the dawn of the day, when the birds are singing and the clouds begin to open up, the first and the best. David would seek God before other things came in to distract or divert his attention. He would seek God before he formed his plans for the day, before other influences came in to control and direct him. I would admonish you to try seeking God in the morning. It will brighten your day. It will refresh it. It will bring sweetness in your wilderness. Amen. You'll be at work going like this, just smiling. All chaos around you, just going like this. Because you know God is in control. The next thing that David shows us is that he confessed his allegiance to the only living God by recognizing who God is to him. David's faith in God enabled him to claim him as his own. You are my God. That's ownership. God wants to be your God. He wants to know where he can fit in. He wants you to know how much he loves you. He wants to see, do you love him? Yes, he does. Next thing David shows us is how God's presence can be in our lives. We must have a thirst. It's a longing for God. It's a little different. It's a little peculiar. It's a longing you can't even explain. You see, not the kind of thirst that the world has, like thirsty for fame or power, like the disciples. Who's the greatest? No. David describes in this particular psalm, poetically, the thirst after water. Have you ever been really thirsty? Have you ever been really thirsty? It can become overwhelming, overpowering as a desire. David's desire for God is like someone who is thirsty, but not just a little thirst. Someone who's dying of thirst. He's so thirsty that his flesh faints. He's like someone in a desperate need of water in a dry and weary land where there is no water. I come to tell you, we're in a dry and weary land, saints. We're in a dry and weary land. We can't even explain it. We wake up in the morning, we hear all the devastation on the news. We're in a dry and weary land. Oh, yes. But in Matthew, it says, blessed are those that hunger and thirst after righteousness. They shall be filled. God wants to send his refreshing water into our dry places, into our barren places. God wants us to learn from David so that we can thrive in our desert season. I thrive in our desert season. God wants us to be able to move freely and not allow what's going on to mess with our minds. We need God in our lives. We can't make it without him. I don't know about you, but I can't make it without him. Hallelujah. The next thing David shows us is how God can be present in our lives. We need a sanctuary. There's another longing. We need a sanctuary. It's not the building, you all. When COVID came, it didn't move me. I had my own sanctuary. I said, okay, God, what you doing here? You're letting us know we can't get down to the house like we want to. When those times happen, you gotta have your own sanctuary to see your power and your glory. David saw God at the tabernacle to connect in some way with God's power and glory. Significantly, David was not at the tabernacle when he sang this particular song. He was in the wilderness of Judah. See, David is showing us, even in your wilderness, you can have a song. I'm going through. I'm going through. You can have your own song. God got my back, and I'm going through. Yet he knew that God's sanctuary was not only a place, but also a spiritual concept that could be entered by faith, no matter where a person was. One of my favorite songs I got connected with when I was in Texas was, Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, and with thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary, oh, for you. Oh, yes. Your sanctuary is God's dwelling place. It allows you to connect with him. I used to hear Pastor Mim say, you got to connect with him. And that's one of my words now. I got to connect with him. Oh, yes. You must have a spiritual mindset. You see, the carnal mind can't grasp this. They can't grasp it. God wants to refresh your thinking. Give me the mind of Christ. I had to ask that. Give me the mind of Christ. I don't want to think the same way I think. I want to think with newness, with refreshing. I want to allow the word of God to change the way I think. And I still have to ask that. I still have to ask that. When I'm driving into my car, road rage hit me. And I said, why she do that? Why he do that? I still got to ask. The Lord said, give me the mind of Christ. David began to reminisce. David remembered to think back, to go back, to look back. And he saw the power of God in the sanctuary. God has brought us through some hills, my sisters and brothers, and some valleys. Some of us wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for the grace of God. I think about Reverend Lemons. He wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for the grace of God. Some of us, we almost lost our mind. Do you hear what I'm saying? Some of us, we almost lost it. Oh, we almost lost this thing. And then some of us, the doctors gave us up. The doctor says, I'm done. There's nothing we can do. But you're here. But you're here. But God saw fit to bring each and every one of us through. If you can think back, go back and think back. Even think about the seen and unseen. You in your car, you made it home safe, but do we know that bullet could have came through? You at home in the kitchen, you on the couch, but that bullet could have came through. We're dealing with a lot of crazy stuff going on today. But God allowed us to be here to tell it. God gave us another chance to tell somebody about the goodness of the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, I shall never forget what he done for me, how he loosed the chains and he set me free. Great is your faithfulness. Great is your faithfulness. Great is your faithfulness. David began to reflect on God, the one who can take care of him, even in his life-threatening situation, when his enemies was hot on his trail. I come to tell you that the enemy is hot on our trails. He wants us to worry. He wants us to be fearful. He wants our focus to be on the deadly pandemic. He wants our health not to be good. And he wants us to forget all about the miraculous healing and the power of God. But the devil is a lie. Oh, he is a lie. Because the word of God says, God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of love, power, and a sound mind. God will give you a sound mind when all of this stuff is going on. God has always been faithful to David, and God has always been faithful to you. And you, Facebook, never forget the goodness of the Lord. That is one thing that will bring you through your desert experience. David shows us how God's presence can be in our lives another way. David says, because your steadfast love is better than life, my lips will praise you. Regardless of what I don't have, God will still love me in spite of. regardless of what I go through, God will still love me in spite of. Some of us get caught up in the necessities of life. But David says, because your steadfast love is better than life, my lips will praise you. David found something better than life. The security that he needed, the peace that he needed, the riches of God's love. It was there before life began. And when all else has passed away, it will remain. It's stronger. It's purer. It's better than life. David says, my lips will praise you as long as I live. We must have a praise in our mouth. If you want to have a release in your wilderness, in your desert, start praising God. I guarantee you, he'll turn the situation around. If you're dealing with some kids that ain't listening, I dare you to start praising God. You're going through something, seem like you ain't gonna make it out. I dare you to start praising God. I dare you that the power of God will bring an anointing. He will bring a release. He will bring a refreshing in your life. Hallelujah. To see the power and the glory of God, David sought God at the tabernacle. Again, there's that word. He connected with his God. He connected with the power of God. Significantly, David was not at the tabernacle, but he sang this song in the wilderness. Yet you knew that God's sanctuary was not only a place, but also a spiritual concept that could be entered by faith. No matter where a person is, better than whatever life can give us. It is even better than continuing to live because his steadfast love will continue on with us in the life and the life to come, even in our struggles and disappointments. I pray today that God will give you strength to go through this. I pray that today. The next thing David does is David has an inner satisfaction. When you seek after God, you will be satisfied. It says, my soul is satisfied as with marrow and fatness. He's never complacent, but satisfied. He said, it's good for the soul. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. David's soul was at rest, even in the middle of his calamity, such as rebellion, which would push many to fall apart emotionally. But David had an inner peace and a calmness, just as you feel physically after eating a delicious meal and you all full and everything. David felt spiritually after feasting on the Lord. You will feel good about it after you didn't feast on the goodness of the Lord. Yes, you will. God's presence in our lives can give us an inner joy, David said. Those who seek after God will have an inner joy. It's something you can't explain. My mouth offers praise with joyful lips. In the shadow of your wings, I will sing, but the king will rejoice in God. David had a joy, not based on circumstances. His whole world was falling apart. But he had the Lord and his loyal love. David could sing and he rejoiced in God. When you seek after God in your inner strength and stability in a crisis during your desert season, you will have that unspeakable joy. I remember my mom was telling me one day, she said, I got that unspeakable joy. I didn't understand what she said. I said, well, she kind of looks loose, a little crazy. But now I done came a little loose, a little crazy. I got the unspeakable joy. I can smile when things are going crazy. Oh, yeah, I can get low in my spirit, man, but I got to praise him. Remember I said you got to praise him. And when you praise him, God will change that change you. The situation might still be there, but God will change you, make you think a little bit better than what you was thinking. David hid under God's wing as a baby chick, hides for protection under the mother's wing. I remember reading a story about owl babies. The owl babies. The mother went, she said, I'm going to go get some food. And the owl baby's sitting on the branches. Here's a little bitty baby. I want my mother. And the little owl said, your mother's coming. She's coming. He said, but I want my mother. Then here come the mother. She finally comes. She swoops down with her wings. She said, you knew I'd come. I come to tell you, you knew he'd come. He'll come and bring you out of your situation. Yes, he will. He'll give you strength in the late midnight hour if you need it. If it's in the morning, he'll give you strength. If it's in the noon, he'll give you strength. He'll give you something. And when you go through this desert season, you'll be jumping and praising God because you know it was nobody but the goodness of the Lord. Amen. And so I just want to thank God this morning. I want to thank God this morning. And I want to close with a prayer and I'm done. I've done what God asked me to do. Father, I praise you this morning. I glorify you. I thank you for this experience, oh God, right now that we've gone through right now, this desert experience is for our good. You got something good that you're doing. And I thank you for the rivers of living water that you send our way to replenish us and restore us and make us rejuvenated for your work. And I ask, oh God, Lord, that this word that you touch everyone in this house, and they will begin to reflect. If they need to make some changes, they'll change their thirst to you. They'll change seeking you instead of the world. They'll change being satisfied. They'll change with the joy in their souls. They'll change, oh God. And oh God, I just thank you this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let's give God another hand. Thank God for Reverend Rosie. Reverend Rosie Hall. Amen. Thank God. You know, it makes a father proud when he sees his children get up and praise God like that. Amen. We come this morning. Let me just thank everyone for my birthday yesterday. I didn't have a party, didn't want one because we're going to be leaving town. But I was on the telephone and reading texts and mail and stuff to 12 o'clock last night. People from all over the world wishing me a happy birthday. Wow. And you know, I tell you, one guy called me and said, well, you caught up with me. He said, you're 73 years old. I said, yeah, I am. I thank God for being around here for 73 years. Amen. Amen. So I want to thank you all for your love and your support. And it just makes me want to just keep on going on like that bunny. Amen. Amen. Thank Pastor Stacy. Amen. When I came back up at 12 o'clock, she said, you've been on the phone all day and night. I said, I am. Praise God. I didn't mean to ignore you, my love. Amen. Amen. So I want to invite you this morning, those of you who are on the listening audience for live stream, I want to thank the people who have come today to celebrate with us the sacrament of Holy Communion and to hear Reverend Rosie preach. Amen. I see some of her relatives here and friends, and I thank God for you. But we're going to go to the prayer of confession, Psalms 51, and we're going to pray together. Would you stand? Verses 1 to 10. Reverend Darrell will put that on the screen if it's not already there. Amen. And we let us pray. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love, according to your abundant mercy. Blot out my transgressions, wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against you, you alone have I sinned, and done what is evil in your sight, so that you are justified in your sentence, and blameless when you pass judgment. Indeed, I was born guilty, a sinner when my mother conceived me. You desire truth in the inward being. Therefore, teach me wisdom in my secret heart. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me and I shall be whiter than snow. Let me hear joy and gladness. Let the bones that you have crushed rejoice. Hide your face from my sins and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new and right spirit in within me. Amen. And now we're going to go over to 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter, and we're going to be reading verses 23 through 26, where we find our words of institution. These are the earliest words that we have that we consecrate the ritual, the sacrament of Holy Communion with. And so Paul writes in 1 Corinthians 11, 23, "For I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way, he took the cup also after supper, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes again.'" Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, for thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Now, as we prepare to take communion, come, Reverend Brian. This is the body of Christ, which is broken for you. I want to have you to stand again after we break consecration. The body of Christ, which is broken for you and me. This is the blood of Christ, which was shed for you and for me.
And it dries up my tears.
Now you may stand. Would you take your cup? Would you take your bread out of your cup? And give the children a minute. This is the body of Christ. Would you take and would you eat? Would you eat? You may eat. Mm-hmm. You can eat it. Mm-hmm. And would you take your cup? And would you drink it? You may drink. This is the blood of Christ. And if you would just hold that for a moment, they will collect your cups.
Yeah.
I know some of us have kind of had a first-time experience with this, and that's okay. I want you to go ahead and eat your bread and drink your juice. Thank you, Lord. Train these kids, amen. 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 Thank you, Jesus. I want to invite you this morning to take the sermon that you've heard to heart. God is going to be with you in your desert experiences. And we're going to enjoy that and feast on that all week. Now we are going to receive the benediction. And let me ask you, Pastor Stacy, do you have a method that you want people to educate Reverend Brian? I'll give the mic to Reverend Brian after we finish the benediction. He'll give us directions on how to do COVID protocol exit. Amen. Thank y'all so much for being here. Thank those of you who are on live stream. We love you. We appreciate your support. We can't make it without you. Now, Lord, we thank you for this service. And we give you all the praise and the glory. And I thank you, Lord, for John's music and the sermon and the prayers and everything, God, we've enjoyed. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Now you go with us as we go back to our homes. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord. May the grace of God, the love of Christ, and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, abide, and keep you now and until we meet again.